To 8 seconds for a good exposure on a printed circuit. Now we're ready to shoot that 1-to-1. Let's go get a printed circuit. Now these circuits are made on Mylar, and they're also taped. Now, Scotty, if you step back, we'll make the exposure. Scotty, after the negative has been made, it goes to quality and then photo tooling.
the Gerber automatic dressing machine. It consists of two major pieces of equipment. One, the plotting table, what you're looking at right now. The other one's over there, and that's the control unit. There's two modes of operation. Right now, it's operating in the high-speed mode. We use that mostly for production of things like schematic diagrams and logic diagrams.
I understand that there are other systems that produce schematics. What's the particular advantage of this system?
Most of the input. The other systems have a very cumbersome input. We don't have that kind of a problem with this system. And you had to locate, as you can see on this diagram, there's symbols. And you had to locate each symbol. In other words, give an X dimension and a Y dimension for each symbol. Our program, you don't have to do that.
In other words, you don't have to have a scale drawing.
No, you don't have to have a scale drawing at all.
Well, is this more economical than doing it by hand?
Well, we've only been in production a while, but we found, on an average, it's about 30% cheaper.
That much?
Yeah. One of the main advantages is the maintenance involved.
I never have been too lucky with the choice. I never get it just right. You know, when I was a little girl, I used to have goldfish. All the time.
Hey there, Fred.
Here, Fred.
Come on. Come on, Bobby. They're getting back. Come on.
Come on. Well, naturally, you put tomatoes and lettuce. And the dressing is what makes it. You put poppy seed dressing on it. It just makes it delicious.
You really got educated.
Put cucumbers in it, and green peppers, and...
Come on, Fred. Come on, Fred.
Talk to him, Freddy.
You talk to Jim. Jim didn't have to talk to you. He flat let old Jim know he really likes it.
What's he? He's about almost 4 years old now, isn't he? I know he was just a little buster when I first came over.
Good food, plenty of good friends, that'd do for you.
go through several cycles on this one.
All right.
Let's see.
That's the first of route gassing.
You're out gassing there.
How's the pressure?
Yeah, it looks like it's following it pretty well, tracking it pretty well in here. And the data's right?
Yeah.
Go through another cycle on that, Carl.
What was your weight requirement on the fixture again?
Less than 50 pounds.
Okay, well, we're within your weight tolerance. What I want to do is evaluate this new lens here. I'm not familiar with the characteristics of the lens. I just want to check its depth of focus
right.
And its resolution in terms of the overall TV system.
Hi, Ed.
What's our first flight profile?
I think we could come in out of altitude and have that oil dump on the other side of the harbor our first target, then swing up, hit the railroad yard.
Fine. Next, we can hit Hoover Dam up here, and then fly over to Friendship Airport.
Jack, I think we'll be running open loop on this one, so we probably won't need control in the computer, but stand by for the next one.
Okay, I'll set in the proper demand loading.
Hey, Ed, what kind of longitudinal closure do you want on this?
Let's run about Mach 1.
What?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, it looks like we're about ready to run. Speaker looks like it's operating okay.
Yeah.
How's that resolve or change to it?
Like we're coming in from 50,000 feet.
Bill, it looks like we're going to end up with a single-page illustration. Now, if the panel nomenclature is the same, we can short it
right.
As we see it here.
The configuration
is
right.
Out here.
You'd have to pull that out and probably do a different breakdown.
Right, we can possibly, if we just have to rotate the sketch and say rotate it 90 degrees and pull the parts out of here, you know, like we normally do, all the tubes and capacitors and so forth.
The cable is going to be pulled off separate. It's going to be rerouted different all through the
And Jose, your facility will simulate the effects of temperature and pressure, but what about flow rates? Do you plan to simulate that also?
For this part of the effort, we've thought that our key parameters are pressure and flux. And as in any research project, we're going to have to evaluate the results that we've gotten from this facility that we have here.
Of course. We need the right facilities to do good research, but beyond facilities, we also have to have good people. We have to keep our people trained.
When I go out and talk to customers about the research work that you're doing, just looking at the people we have and assessing their abilities to do the kind of research he wants done, and then do we have the right equipment in order to accomplish that research. So it's a constant trade-off of materials, people, and the equipment to do the job.
It certainly is, and of course, added to that is the capability that we have from an educational standpoint in Central Florida.
Thank you.